Hello, hello friends. My name is Tatiana, and you see that flowers, those flowers behind my back, and I'm gonna paint it today with you, in your company, and I'm gonna play around with watercolor, and we'll see what happens. Всем привет! Сегодня я порисую в прямом эфире цветы акварелью. У меня вот целая коллекция за мной, как видите. И я обычно рисую почти на столе, почти у меня горизонтально бумага находится. Сегодня вот буду рисовать почти вертикально. Посмотрим, что получится. I'm gonna move my camera a little bit. And I have Saunders Waterford paper. This is gonna be a new experience for me because I used to paint on arches. So this is my first time actually painting wet into wet on Saunders. And I pre-wet it already. Yes, I agree with you, it's weird a little bit. I have a big collection of jars and I use them for my still lives. So I have a lot of flowers in front of me, but I'm going to paint just, you know, some of them. It's like gonna be an exercise for me. So I'm not anticipated to paint a masterpiece. Сегодня шедевра не будет. У меня не собираюсь рисовать шедевр. А просто буду. Как это сказать, тренироваться в таких необычных условиях, поскольку у меня сейчас все здесь будет растекаться, и бумага новая, и, в общем, посмотрим. And I'm gonna start with just my primaries, with my primary colors, red, blue, and yellow. It's gonna be more, maybe more abstract, floral painting. So I'm gonna. I see here one big pink rose, and it's gonna be my focal point. So I'm using a makeup sponge, and so this is gonna be a big pink rose. Here's it's gonna be some coronation. I don't know, this like blue flowers gonna be here. And a few roses gonna be here. Big white rose in this area. And this is my composition. Okay, and So if you have any questions, please ask. I will try my best and answer. Если у вас есть вопросы, пишите. Я буду посматривать на время от времени и по возможности отвечу. So I have my basic primary colors, but also I have some additional paints today. I have cerulean blue from Rembrandt. I like it. And maybe I will use rose sienna from Mijello. Okay, we'll see. Yes, rose sienna right away. Gonna use it for these flowers, for the center. If it's still wet, I can do it right now. And another big magenta rose gonna be here. A lot of opera from Holbein. Another big rose here, and use my makeup sponge to remove some paint. So I'm adding and removing. Darks on my focal point. I'm not sure about this one, but and this brush, it's new for me. It's from Princeton, Dakota series, Angular Bright. So I really like it. I just recently bought it. Okay, and this area I'm going to add some green. Using my primary colors. Plus cerulean blue. I think I lost my white carnations. It's here. So So it's fun when you have a lot of flowers in front of you. You can choose the part you like. And for example, I have also hydrangea. So it's not close to this big rose, but I can just move on my paper this hydrangea, and it's good. It's gonna be good for my composition, and I can still have the opportunity to paint it from life. У меня передо мной много цветов, и я могу как бы создавать композицию уже на бумаге, то есть рисовать то один цветок, то другой цветок, и как бы у меня, я создаю этот натюрморт не в реальности, а уже на бумаге, использую как бы большее количество цветов, чем если бы было, если бы я поставила просто вот и перед собой определенный букет и его бы там вырисовывала. То есть это как бы дает больше свободы. So here I have another white rose, but I'm gonna just save this space, and I'm gonna use Halbin shadow green and Indian red. Gives me dark green. Also gonna add more dark green to this area. Bit of texture. Yeah, it's not bad, that paper, I like it, but honestly, I like arches more. So it's easier to remove paint from arches. But I'm sure this is a good paper, just for my style, it's probably a little bit not right. Big dry brush. Clean my palette. смою палитру, потому что хочу сделать еще парочку розочек в этой area. I'm gonna paint a few more roses in this area. I use Opera, Cerulean Blue. And Cerulean Blue has a lot of white in there, so it's not transparent and we need to be very careful when we paint with not transparent paint. Let's start drying in this area. Here is the suggestion of my hydrangea. So I definitely lost my carnation, but it's okay. Sometimes I can remove, I have an ability to remove paint with a thirsty brush, but it's kind of difficult on that paper. A little bit easier with the sponge. And I feel like I need to paint something here. Let me try. I have a big size of paper, pretty big I think, 16 by 20. So this is the nice Holbein paint, John Brion, number two, a little bit more. On the warmer side. Okay, let's give some darks to this rose. Немного деталей этой розочки. And more definition to this rose. So sometimes I like drips, sometimes here I think I don't like them here, so it's really fun to work on the, with the, on that vertical position, because I really need to work fast. And make corrections. Adding and removing. Again, shadow green. Let's add more darks. A little bit of Indian red. Here is the few strokes. Here is likely, I think this is the thistle. Я забыла, как называется эта колючка по-русски. Английский thistle. I'm gonna pretend this stem starts here and I will continue. Maybe for some movement. Watercolor is such a wonderful medium. So much room for experimenting. You can try different paper, different paints, different brushes, and every time it's gonna be different. This is just awesome. Smaller brush. This is my hydrangea. I almost lost it, but it's back. I don't know the name of this blue flowers. And I feel like I need something blue here in this area, just for the sake of color balance. Maybe some blue in this area too. Oh, right, because I have a rose here. Big dry brush. I don't need this sharp edge. I'm gonna use wet napkin. That's too late, because here it's dry already. Okay, some darks here inside these two flowers. I'm gonna use Alizarin Crimson and Opera. Maybe little bit of turquoise green, dark turquoise green. Ah, it's already dry. Maybe it wasn't a good idea. Иногда уже лучше не трогать, потому что когда уже сухая бумага, уже вот как здесь, уже получается не то, что хочется. А бумага сухнет быстро, быстрее, чем обычно, поскольку вертикальный формат, и он достигает. Yeah, I think I need to stop because I'm making this worse. We need to stop in the right time. Because I can lose the freshness of my painting. But I'm kind of satisfied with this exercise. I was just trying to loosen up a little bit, because recently I feel I'm kind of tight with my watercolor. Okay, I think that's better. I definitely need to stop, but I can't. Just, you know, the process. I'm gonna correct. I feel like I need to correct here and there, a little bit here, a little bit there, but it's so important to stop in the right time. Maybe just a few thistles. Okay, I think that's about it. I think that's enough for, you know, for this very quick floral watercolor exercise. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this quick video. And see you soon, guys. Всем спасибо, кто присоединился. Было интересно такое сделать мне сегодня маленькое акварельное упражнение. Всем спасибо и до новых встреч. Всем пока-пока.